I don't care how special your mommy thinks you are, how long you pray to God at night, that is not enough to affect a buildup of muscle mass beyond normal levels. There is and can be only one valid theory of productive bodybuilding exercise, and it just so happens to be the theory of high-intensity training.
What is up, YouTube? It is Tuesday, January 6th, and we are at Anytime Fitness PHX hitting legs. I've already done a little bit of a warm up. We did adductor, abductor, and then I typically will go directly into a heavy squat motion, typically not barbell squat. I've been running hack squat lately, however this gym does not have a good hack squat, but we do have this behind me, this hammer strength V squat, which I like. So we are about to get started with a warm up here. We got two plates loaded on either side, and I actually hit hamstring curls first today, which my hamstrings are just fucking pumped. Like, it was hard for me to sit down right now. So we'll see how this impacts my quad workout. I typically always like to hit quads first because I like them fresh, and my hamstrings are a little bit more developed than my quads. I'm trying to bring my quads up. However, I have heard from a couple YouTubers and from a couple articles online that hitting hamstrings first should not impact your quad strength, and it should just make you feel a little bit fuller and more pumped. So we're giving it a try today. All right, we will run this until I'm fucking gassed, and then we may do a couple sets of leg press, or no, I think I'm gonna actually do, I haven't done these in like a year, but I think after this I will do some Smith machine sissy squats. And then leg extensions to finish off. And we may do some stiff-legged deadlift, or we may just run seated hamstring curls, and then a whole bunch of calf shit, but that's pretty basic. Hamstrings first, they're like so fucking pumped that it's like uncomfortable to stand, but I don't think it's really affecting my quad work right now, so it's a little bit uncomfortable to move around. I am trying to be better, more thoughtful with my words, and a little bit more intentional with these videos, so hopefully they get better over the next couple weeks. I've been feeling pretty good, totally following my coach's diet plan, like to a T. The only thing I wasn't doing before was having the scoop of protein in the middle of the night and then having my eggs in the morning, because that was putting me over what my previous calories were, just 2400. With the scoop of protein and the eggs, it's like 2650. But I have been doing that the last couple days just because I was feeling like super low energy and shitty, I think, because there's not enough fats without the eggs. Even with them, it's like still super low fats, but whatever, man. I'm just gonna trust the process, trust my coach, and run this shit. But yeah, digestion's been great. I know I expressed a little bit of concern about so much protein powder in the chest video last week, but yeah, I've just been adding a scoop of fiber to the shakes that I have that do not have oats with them. And honestly, my digestion's been so great recently. So that's been super nice. What else? Yeah, so I was supposed to go back home, take a vacation back home and help my mom recover from a knee surgery. However, her recovery went smoother than expected. She's already back at work. So I am actually just going to, I was supposed to fly out yesterday. I did not fly out. I postponed the trip. So I'm gonna start training with Curtis. Like we're gonna actually start everything, start check-in, start officially training on this upcoming Monday. So I'm excited for that. We'll start a new gear protocol, which is Primo Sustanon, which if you don't know, Sustanon is just a multi-ester blend of testosterone. So I think it's like test sip, test, and esters. If you don't know what an ester is, it's essentially the, it's what determines the half-life of compounds. So we have like test cypionate and testosterone enanthate, which enanthate and cypionate are just the esters it's with. Those are both a little bit longer half-life, but then you also have stuff like test propionate, which is a lot shorter of a half-life. So it just means it's in and out of your system a little bit quicker. But sustanon is just multiple different esters, so it's kind of like both instant and extended release of the testosterone. So we're gonna give that a try, and then Primo, and what else? I think he has me taking 30 milligrams of Anavar pre-workout every day. So we'll see how, and then I'm gonna run. I'm gonna continue my growth protocols, and I may not tell him this, but may leave a little tren in there. Just in the background, not 350 a week, but maybe like 100 trying a week. Yeah, super excited to start that. Trying to upload reels daily to Instagram and film some more longer form YouTube. Still hovering right around like 200 on the cut. Again, I'm kind of like upping my calories. So I've been actually kind of maintaining my weight even though I've been doing less cardio and eating more calories. So what I was doing before for my cardio was 30 minutes of stair stepper, 7 days a week. What he has me doing now is just 5 days a week, treadmill, 8 incline, and like 3.2 speed. A little bit less taxing on the system. My knees are definitely feeling a little bit better. I have more energy and then eating a little bit. So yeah, my weight kind of moved up. That's because I'm changing a couple things and I kind of expect it to, you know, keep dropping down again. All right, let's get this first working set. What the hell am I doing here?
I'm a winner. whatever you want. You're so fucking special. I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong here.
Yeah. Failure.
So we came very, very, very close to throwing up after that last set on B squat, which is a sign that I am doing something right. It's been a minute since I've thrown up on leg day, which I typically like to, because it means I push myself really fucking hard. But I've been going like heavy, heavy, heavy on legs, and which is good, but typically end my set like right when I fail, or on that, you know, one rep in reserve, like one rep before failure. What I've been doing is getting to that point and locking out, resting for a little bit, and you'll see it in the clips, and then continuing to do one more rep as many times as I can, until one RIR, you know, of the myo reps or to failure. On the last set, I did fail after I did the myo reps, and holy shit, like I have not had a fucking quad pump like this in a minute, and I've not felt like this in a minute. Like, I'm still kind of sick to my stomach. I don't know if I'm gonna actually do the sissy squats though, because I'm fucking destroyed from that. I'll probably just end up doing leg extensions, and I've already been here for an hour and a half, so. Okay, let's blast these calves. This will be our warm-up set, and then we'll probably slap a 35 on either side.
My soul straight down out of the world, but my fingers holding on to the devil. I know all my troubles are hanging your trigger. Take your eyes and your mind from the road. Shoot your mouth if you know you're aiming. Don't forget to pick up what you sow. Talking trash to the garbage around you.
Tell that was joyfully light for me. I got some fucking strong calves, boy. I'm just gonna sit here for a minute and just bask in the glory of this quad pump. Oh, it's been fucking too long. Well, actually, the last leg day I did at the gym in the dungeon, I did the same thing. I did my reps and partials on hack squat and just got fucking obliterated. So I need to continue to do my reps for legs, because I do partials, right, for all upper and everything. I do partials at the end, but it's hard for me to do partials on like a squat or a pressing motion, because if you fill them, then you're all the way in the bottom of the hole, so I don't do them. But the myo reps are good. Holy fuck, dude, I can literally feel my fucking quad veins through my pants right now. Like, I'm fucking commando today, but if I did have boxers on, I would definitely drop my pants right now and show you guys. I thought about putting boxers on before I came, but I have small legs, so I was like, fuck it, dude. I don't even want to take my pants off because there's nothing to show down there. Talk to the management here again, the homeless lady that followed me into the bathroom last week. I talked to them about it. They told me she was banned, and she's in here. again and just fucking stared me down. So I will talk to them again about it, and she will be banned.
My bones and the anvil of daylight.
It's probably honestly a little bit too much weight. You will not grow if you never push yourself, so we shall continue to push. She comes in here and she just fucking runs through like all their supplies, dude. She comes and she fucking runs the whole roll of toilet paper. Then I literally just saw her over there just fucking running all the wipes out of the fucking container. Why are you coming to the gym to steal all their fucking supplies and bother people? Fuck off, lady. If you're not in here to work out and use the facility correctly, don't fucking be in here. Okay, there's no reason to focus on negativity though. I'm an asshole. Oh my god, I'm a fucking asshole, dude. And guess what? I love you. Maybe 2-3 more sets here. Sidetracked my fucking forearms look huge. So my bicep, fucked up the bicep on, it's Tuesday today, the 9th, the 6th. I fucked up my bicep my last arm day, which was on Friday. Just like slightly overtrained it. So I always, for arms, I always hit triceps first and then biceps secondary. I was watching like a bro chat podcast and Ian said something about like he liked to hit biceps first because it made him feel warmer, blah, blah, blah. I was like, fuck it, I'll try to hit biceps first. Hit biceps first, went fucking heavy on my dumbbell curls, curled to 50s, felt okay. Like wasn't really getting a crazy pump or anything, but felt all right. And, but then like when I go to lay down to go to sleep on Friday night, I'm like, fuck, dude, like my bicep was fucked up. And then Saturday went to train chest and really like couldn't fully do any flying motions because just that little bit of tension on my bicep was too much for it to handle. So I did like kind of a half-ass chest and delt workout on Saturday. And then I skipped on Sunday because I just needed to recover. My bicep was pretty fucked up and there was no way I was gonna be able to train back. Then on Monday, I retrained chest and delts. I got like a full workout because the bicep was healed. And now today is Tuesday. I should have done back today, but I didn't want to like overexert the bicep and potentially like repotentiate the issue. So I'm training legs. I also think it's probably smart to do, right, like chest and delts, legs, back, arms, chest and delt. Wait, I don't know. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. Essentially, what I'm trying to do is like split up the tension on muscle groups. So I'm at least giving something like a 24 to 48 hour recovery window. So like, for example, I don't want to hit arms and then hit back the next day because if I'm hitting biceps for arms, yeah, okay, while I'm hitting back, it's not a bicep motion, but your bicep is like a secondary mover in any like pulling motion. So I'm trying to like space that out. So like I wouldn't want to hit arms and then back immediately next day. I would want to maybe hit arms and then legs and then back and then chest and delt and then arms, legs, back, chest and delt. I don't know. There's going to be a little bit of overlap no matter how you structure it. This is never going to be perfect, but that's what I'm doing right now is technically an 8-day split, no rest days. So like 4 and 4 repeating, but what my coach has me doing is instead of hitting like everything twice a week and then one muscle group like once a week, he has me hitting chest twice, back twice, shoulders once, legs once, and arms once, which I don't know how I feel about that because I feel like my legs need a lot of work comparatively to my upper body, and especially not my chest, or definitely not my back. I feel like I should only be training back once a week. That's probably my most developed, but again, he's the pro. I'm just trusting the process. I'm trusting what he says. I'm trusting his vision, and we're just gonna run with it. So we have not been following his training split, but that will start on Monday. For fucking calves today. The next level of freakazoid is when you can fucking see your veins through your pants. That's the level I'm trying to be at. Oh, maybe you kind of can see a couple outlines a little bit here, man. Oh, I am so ready for the shreds. I'm sure you can't see them on the camera, but I can kind of see one like right in here and I can feel it. Number two, I am doing a little bit lighter weight than my max loads, maybe like 65 to 75%. And we're going nice and slow and controlled, focusing on a crazy contraction and a deep, deep stretch. Fucking sore already that this brace is killing them. I think we'll do one more here. Get this last set.
Thank you.
partials always fucking get me so pumped. If I was to just strictly do working sets and no intensifiers, I think I would have a shitty workout, every single workout. Cause like my failure point comes so quickly and I just cannot, like no matter how much I try, I'm just tapped, dude. And I just cannot contract the muscle. But I can still like squeeze out partials. And that's what really gets me fucking pumped. Same thing with the my reps on legs. That just fucking, or even drop sets, right? I used to do drop sets all the time instead of partials. But there's been a lot of new studies that long length partials, so in the stretch position, are like the best intensifier for muscle growth. So I've been doing partials instead. It's also just a little bit easier. You don't have to drop any weight. You can just keep, you know, going until you can literally only move it an inch. We're done here. We're gonna go hit a couple sets of leg extensions and probably honestly just one or two, maybe three, and then get the fuck out of here. I hope nobody needs to hear this, but with leg extensions, you wanna make sure you have this thing set, like right the foot thing, all the way back so you get the biggest stretch.
Boy, I got my mind on cake.